Hello, and welcome back to the PI WebParts 2013 SP1 installation video series. In this final video, we will be testing WebParts, and I'll be showing the differences between using a PI mapping and a PI trust for your PI security. First, to recap, I want to remind you that I've already created a mapping for my user, mapping to the PI identity PI WebParts user. I also created a trust, but right now I am disabling that trust, so I cannot come through using that trust. Now, I want to test my PI WebParts installation. So, I'm here on my WebParts machine. The first place you want to test your WebParts connection is at the WebParts admin page. The URL for the admin page is the name of your WebParts machine, so in my case, Sterling. Then underscore layouts or slash underscore layouts slash pi underscore webparts slash admin dot aspx. This URL is also in the PI WebParts administration guide. If you try to connect to this site and you get an error saying access denied or this was not shared with you, and you know you should have access to it because you're the SharePoint admin, the issue may be that claims to Windows token service is not running. So to resolve that, simply start it in your services and then try to access this page again. Once you're at this page, you want to go to PI data sources. And at the PI data sources page, you'll see a list of all your configured PI servers. I only have one at the moment. If this list is populated, that means SharePoint and PI WebParts services are communicating as expected. And that's a good sign. You also want to test your connection to the configured PI server. So you want to highlight your PI server and click Test Connection here on the right. And a window will pop up giving you the results. You can see I connected with my username, getting the identity PI WebParts user. This is telling me that Kerberos is working correctly, and I'm going through that mapping I set up. It also lets you know how the service account running PI WebParts services is coming in. So it gives me the account it's coming in with, as well as the PI identity it gets, which is PI WebParts service account. If you weren't able to connect, it will let you know in this window, but I am, so we can go on and continue testing WebParts by going and creating a SharePoint page. To prove to you that I'm using a mapping, I'm going to go on my PI server. And I can view my connections by going to Operation, Network Manager Statistics. And if we scroll down, we'll find W3WP, which is the application name. I'm going to scroll all the way over to the right, and you'll see the user is my user and the service account. So both of those are coming in for this application. This proves that I am using a PI mapping over a PI trust. So I'm going to go to my SharePoint site, which is just Sterling, or the name of your SharePoint machine. And to create a site in SharePoint 2013, we go to Site Contents, then Site Pages. And here we're going to want to create a WebPart page. To do that, you go to File, and do the drop-down for New Document and select WebPart Page. In SharePoint 2010, the way to get there is Site Actions, More Options, and then from the window that pops up, you'll find WebPart Page in the list. You do want to make sure you use a WebPart Page when you are using PI WebParts. To create a page, you simply have to give it a name. So I'm just going to call it WebParts Test. I'm going to use the default layout, but you can select a different layout template if you'd like. And I'm also going to keep it in Site Pages. You can change the library if you prefer. And I'm just going to hit Create. So this is my site that I just created, and I'm going to add some PI web parts here. So I'll just select Add a web part. I'm just doing it in the middle column. And I'll scroll down here in the categories and find PI web parts. If you do not see PI WebParts in this list, it is likely because you did not activate the site collection feature. So if you don't see PI WebParts here, activate the site collection feature, then come back and try to edit your page again. I'm just going to add a PI trend. So select PI trend and then select add. So here's my trend, but I haven't configured anything for it yet. So to do that, if you hover over the top, you'll see this arrow and click the drop down and select edit web part. When you select edit web part, a pane will show up on the right, and this is how you will edit your web part. So I'm just going to search for some data using this the cube with the binoculars, and a window will pop up. This is how you select your data. First, I'm just going to search my PI server. So in this first drop-down next to home, I'll see my AF server, which you can see with the symbol with the box, and my PI server, which kind of looks like a computer with a tag next to it. So I'll select my PI server, and I'll search sinusoid asterisk, and do a search. And you'll notice that I actually see the list of all the sinusoids on my system, even though my user only has access to view data for some of them. This list is populated just because of exactly how the security is set up, but you'll see if I select both sinusoid and sinusoid U, I'll add those. And I'll also do a search for CD asterisk. And again, I'll find all of them, but I'll bring in CDT158 as well as CDEP158. So add those. Once I'm done adding, I'll select OK. You'll see everything you added populated here in this list. And once you have all that configured, you can just select Apply. Now, if you remember, my user only had access to Sinusoid and CDT158. So even though I have all four of those in this trend, you'll see only two traces pop up. One for CDT158 and one for Sinusoid. You'll see Sinusoid U and Sinusoid EDP158 look like they have no data to my user, even though there's actually data in the PI server. That's because I don't have access to it. If someone who did have access to all four of these tags came on the same website, they would see all four traces. And you can see there's a message here saying that it could not find the PI point. Again, that's because I do not have permission to it. That's one advantage of using a PI mapping, is you can narrow down security more, because maybe someone has only the permissions to access some tags and not others. You can make a page with multiple on it, and they'll only get access to the ones they have permission to. So now, instead of looking directly at the PI server, I'm going to look at the AF server. So I'm going to clear this list, and again, I'm going to search PI data. This time, I'm going to look at my AF server, and I'm going to pick a new database called OSIsoft Plant. I'm going to go down to Equipment Maintenance, find my tanks, go to Mixing Tank 1, and I actually want to search everything here. So these are all the attributes for my mixing tank 1. I happen to know that external temperature and internal temperature use tags I'm allowed to view, while the rest don't. So I'm going to select external temperature, internal temperature, and then I'll select level, mixer speed, and pressure. So I only have access to two of the tags that these are actually mapped to. The rest I don't have access to. So even though I can see the attributes, when I populate this list and hit apply, you'll see that I get no data for the ones I do not have access to view. So if I scroll up to the top, I can see external temperature and internal temperature, but not level, mixer speed, or pressure. Again, those three attributes actually have data, it's just my user can't see them. Again, I'll look at this message, and it'll let me know that those three PI points can't be found, and that's because I do not have access to them. So again, showing the advantages of using a PI mapping. And even though I can see those attribute names, I can't see the values. Now that I got this working with a PI mapping, in case you can't use PI mappings for any reason, like you can't set up Kerberos, I'm going to show you how it looks when using a PI trust. I'm going to go back to my PI server machine. I'm going to disable this mapping I've been coming through. So let's double click it, select mapping is disabled. Go to my trust and enable the trust I created before, and then select OK. Now I'm going to go back. Now I'm back on my SharePoint and WebParts machine. I'm going to get out of Internet Explorer. To force a disconnect, I'm just going to do an IIS reset. This is just going to make sure that I use the new way of connecting, so using the PI trust instead of a PI mapping. And once that starts back up, I'm going to go back to Internet Explorer, and I'm going to go back to my WebParts admin page. I'm going here just to show you how it will look different if you're using a trust rather than a mapping to connect to your PI server. Go back to PI data sources. And again, I'm going to test connection. You'll see that my service account came in the same, but my user came in with PI WebParts service account. That is because that is the identity that the trust I'm connecting with uses. So even though it gives me my Windows user, it's coming in through a PI trust. So if I go back to my SharePoint machine, and to prove to you it's coming in with the PI trust, if I go back to my PI server machine, if I go to Operations, Network Manager Statistics, scroll down, the application is called W3WP. You can see there's actually multiple things coming in. One is the user, svc-tspiwebclientsv. That is how the service account is connecting. But then you'll see we're also coming through this PI WebParts trust. And that is how my specific user is actually coming in. And if we look at the trust, it's using the PI WebParts service account identity. Now that we're at the SharePoint page, I'm going to go to Site Contents, Site Pages. I'm just going to use the page I created before, so WebParts Test. And we'll see. And we'll see I have access to all of the AF attributes. Because I'm coming in with a PI trust, I get access to everything that trust allows. And anyone that is connecting to WebParts through SharePoint is gonna have access to all these tags. So if I actually did not have permission to see pressure, then then using a PI trust would not be a good way of narrowing down the access. Even if everyone can view everything, and you don't care who's actually connecting through WebParts, we recommend using PI mappings. It is still more secure. Thank you for watching the PI WebParts 2013 SP1 installation video. I hope this has helped you install our newest version of WebParts, and I hope you enjoy the access to PI data on your SharePoint pages.